What is going on, guys and gals? My name is Schematocles, and man, oh man, am I glad to be back in X-Plane 11 today. We're sitting on the tarmac in LaGuardia in New York, and we're going to be doing a full flight up to Logan International in Boston in the MD-82, and it's sunset, so we might get to see some nice city lights as we arrive in Boston. So let's go ahead and get underway here. Go ahead and file our flight plan. Going to be going to Boston at a cruise altitude of 21,000 feet today. Pretty simple flight plan. That's it. Okay, let's file that. Go ahead and request altimeter here.
Number 552 Alpha Alpha Kilo Lima Golf Alpha Altimeter 2992.
Standard altimeter.
Kilo Lima Golf Alpha Altimeter 2992. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
All right, we'll go ahead and request our clearance.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Cleared IFR to Kilo Bravo Oscar Sierra as file. Maintain flight level 210. Squawk 4700.
Okay, the transponder's already set.
And we are cleared. Kilo, Bravo, Oscar, Sierra, as filed. Maintain flight level 210. Squawk 4700. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Let's go ahead and set this up here. LaGuardia is the departing. Arriving at Logan. Okay, there we go. So that should be more or less ready now. Let's look on over here. Oops. And check that flight plan. Okay, looks fine. All right, so we're more or less ready to go ahead and request taxi here. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the flight director and the autopilot. Whoops. Just switch the autopilot over to 2 there, and I keep doing it. Okay. Let's go ahead and request taxi.
November 552 Alpha Alpha runway 31 taxi via 11418371 hold short of runway 4.
Okay.
Runway 31. Taxi via 11418371. Hold short of 4. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Beautiful American livery on our MD-82 today. All right, so we're cleared to taxi. Let's go ahead and request pushback.
Sending push card now.
Here he comes. Go ahead and release the parking brake for him.
Here we go.
Alrighty. Again, really glad to be back in flight sims. Work's just been absolutely insane for me for about the last 10 days, so that's why my uploads haven't been on point. But that should change. Gonna have a relatively relaxed week next week and this weekend. So get ready for that. Gonna be a lot of videos coming down the pipeline. I'll talk about those a little bit more once we're kind of up in the air here. But I really appreciate the support from you guys. At last count, I think we had 210 subs, which is just unbelievable given that at the beginning of February, I think we had like 55. So that's plus 300%. Just blows my mind. Can't thank you guys enough for that support. And I think it's awesome that we're kind of spreading the word about aviation and why this is kind of an important thing to inform people about in society. All right. And we're just gonna follow the taxi line more or less. There have been a few updates since I've done a full commercial flight with ATC, so hopefully they will have improved it some. And it already appears to me that they have. This taxi line is looking much more correct than it normally would, just from my experience. So that's good. I think Lameter's done a really good job of constantly improving the beta, to be honest. One feature I'd really like to see implemented would be air-to-air refueling. for reasons that I'll talk about in just a little bit. But really looking forward to that coming down the pipeline. It's early morning when I'm shooting this, just because this is probably the only time today that I'm going to be able to record. So I got a nice cup of coffee here in front of me.
November.
Help me wake up.
2 Alpha. Contact tower on 118.7.
Yeah, so this is looking much better on the ATC already. This is what you would expect.
118.7. November. 552 Alpha. Alpha.
All right, let's check in with tower. This still takes too long to switch.
November. 552 Alpha. Alpha.
November. 552 Alpha. Alpha. Cross runway 4. Hold short of runway 3-1.
Yeah, this is much better.
Cross 4. Hold short of.
That's
three,
awesome.
1. November. 552 Alpha. Alpha.
It seems to me that they've really, really worked on this ATC. Before, you would never get to contact tower before you cross the runway or anything like that. It was all kind of handled by ground, which it shouldn't be. You should already be on tower well before you are holding short of your departure runway. Kind of a lengthy taxi today, but that's okay. No worries at all. All right, so I guess we can go ahead and set up the autopilot here. We'll be flying, heading at 310, or whatever the actual runway heading is. Okay. Keep that at 7,000 for right now. Don't know about any altitude restrictions yet. I think when we switch this into vertical speed mode, we'll have to reset this, but that's fine. Same goes for the auto throttle and the speed select mode. That's interesting. So it went ahead and revved up there for the auto throttle, even though we weren't in speed select. So that's a bit weird. There are a few little oddities to the autopilot. I'm not sure if those are just me not being aware of what I'm doing, or if they're actual, you know, bugs, but we'll talk about a few of those as we go here. Voice is a little bit froggy this morning. Sorry about that, guys. Sound like I smoked like 6 packs of cigarettes yesterday. Okay. All right, here's the active. Go ahead and hold short.
November 5, November.
There we go.
5-5-2.
Yeah, this is perfect. The ATC's
310. Runway 31. Clear for takeoff.
Really working much better now.
Heading 310. Runway 31. Cleared for takeoff. November.
So flaps to 1.
5-2 Alpha. Alpha.
Yeah, because typically you have to kind of pull, like, almost onto the active just to get a call from tower. I mean, this is leaps and bounds better than what I've been dealing with in the past, so. Very exciting. All right. Okay, runway 31 confirmed, and let's go ahead and cross-check that with the heading. Looks like more of a 316 type heading. Go ahead and set that. Okay, flight director is on, autopilot is on, altitude set to 7,000. That's fine for right now. We'll set the auto throttle once we're underway. Okay, everything looks more or less good to go here. Flaps are set for takeoff. Let's go ahead and get this thing up in the air. All right, we'll rev to 50% in one. Okay, appears to be stable. Brake release, full power. There's the Manhattan skyline up in front of us there. Airspeed's alive. 100 knots. Rotated 140. Alright, positive rate, gear up. Flaps coming up. Pull back on that power just a little bit. Go ahead and set auto throttle here.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Contact center on 125.32.
It set me into mock select and says speed.
Contact center on 125.32. November 552 Alpha Alpha. Center, November, 552, Alpha, Alpha.
November, 552, Alpha, Alpha, Kilo, Lima, Golf, Alpha, Altimeter, 2-9-9-2. November, 552, Alpha, Alpha, Y heading, 220.
220.
Heading, 220, November, 552, Alpha, Alpha.
Whoops. It's a little bit finicky just to kind of deal with all the dials there. Okay. And that should be more or less everything.
552 Alpha Alpha. Y heading 220.
We are working on it.
Heading 220.
Okay, gears up, flaps are set to 0.
Alpha Alpha.
And there's Manhattan below us.
November 552 Alpha Alpha.
So they still do the two call thing for one turn, which is odd, but gosh, I keep doing that. Okay, there we go.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Y heading 040.
Three calls.
Heading 040. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Alrighty. We are well underway here. We don't have any altitude restrictions, so I'm just going to go ahead and assume that we can continue this climb right on up to our cruise altitude. Beautiful evening for flying. Clear skies. Take a look at that Manhattan skyline in just a second. There it is. Someone pointed out that those are actually X-plane symbols on those towers from my Sikorsky VFR Manhattan tour video, so that's pretty cool. Did not realize that at the time, even though I flew right past them.
2 Alpha Alpha. Contact center on 134.7.
All right, switching.
Contact center on 134.7. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Come on.
Center November 552 Alpha Alpha.
November 552 Alpha Alpha Kilo Lima Golf Alpha Altimeter 2992.
Kilo Lima Golf Alpha Altimeter 2992. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
All right. So we are well underway. Everything appears to be going smoothly at this point. Probably be nighttime once we get into Boston, which is exactly what I wanted to do. Just figured I'd start the video actually being able to see the airplane and stuff. Really like the feel of the MD-82. I don't know what it is about it. It feels like a little bit more sleek than the 7.3, a little bit less like cumbersome. I guess just because the cockpit is narrower. I don't know. It feels like more sporty. I don't really know how to describe it. Really do like this airplane, though. I think the cockpit model is actually a little bit superior to the 7.3, in my opinion. Okay, we need to go ahead and turn on our pitot heat, since I think it's... I think it's winter. We don't want to take any chances. All right. Beautiful airplane. Beautiful evening. Beautiful sunset over there. Very relaxing. Okay, and we are through 10,000 feet here, so I'm going to go ahead and kill the lights, and I will retract those. Because apparently they cause extra drag, I have been informed, so... Thank you for that suggestion, that information. Okay, let's go ahead and switch the map up the range just a little bit. Okay, it looks like we're off of our flight plan, but I'm sure they'll give us a turn call and get us back on that first fix. Coffee. The best. So a little bit about the videos that I'm working on right now, guys. I know I said something about this in the last one, but effectively what I'm trying to do right now is an SR-71 cross-country record. I believe from LAX to Dulles International, and I actually made an attempt at that 2 days ago. And was extremely unsuccessful. I got to Kansas City, which is, you know, about midway across the country, maybe a little bit more, and ran out of gas, which is very odd because I actually set my fuel to longer than 2 hours worth of cruise, but I died at about 45 minutes, so kind of unfortunate. But I'll be attempting that again, I'm sure. So that's kind of why I was saying that I want to to get air-to-air refueling kind of implemented. That would be pretty nice, I feel, because typically the SR needed to refuel pretty much immediately upon taking off. So if I take off and then link up with a tanker, take on pretty much a full fuel load, I think I could get across the country, no problem. So that's what I've been working on. I figure nobody's going to try and steal my video idea or anything. The only people watching at this point are going to be, you know, the hardcore fans, so I appreciate you. Another little thing I've been working on, I got the Panavia Tornado GR4 from X-Trident, hoping that it would work in X-Plane 11, but it turns out that there are actually a few issues with it. in the beta, so I'm actually having to go back to X-Plane 10 to kind of do a video on that, and that's also coming. So stay tuned for that. It should be pretty interesting. I actually really like the airplane. It's very cool. Just the whole concept of a swing wing is, I don't know, fascinating to me. That fighter's really highly specialized. It can do a lot of different things, like strike interdictor missions for low-level bombing or interception or anything. And it's, I don't know, it's pretty cool. So hopefully I'll be able to actually get that working in X-Plane 11. I've actually gotten the flight model to load and been able to fly the airplane, but I had kind of an issue where I couldn't close the canopy all the way. And I'm not really sure what the deal is with that. But hopefully I'll be able to figure it out. Okay, we should be getting a turn call any minute here. Unless ATC just forgot about us. Only about 100 miles from Boston at this point. So again, pretty short flight. Nice and easy.
November 5-5. There we go. Alpha. Fly heading 090.
Got it, boss. Whoops. Oh, that's weird. Can't actually see the labels for turning the dials. That's kind of a problem, I feel. Huh. Alright, another one of those beta glitches. That's fine. I should probably call that back, huh?
Heading 090, November 552, Alpha.
Okay, yeah, and they've got us lined up pretty much perfectly with that first waypoint, so we'll actually probably be flying 090 for the rest of the way in. Ah, night flight. So calming. It's actually pretty cool because we're flying to the... Actually, no, this is backwards from how it should be, because we're technically flying to the east. Oh, no, never mind. I'm just an idiot. The sun does set in the west, so this is absolutely correct. So the sun's setting behind us, and we're flying into darkness. All right, I'm going to go ahead and set cruise speed here. Whoops. Got to be very careful with this. I'm not really too sure what the deal is right now. Why I'm not able to see the labels. But that's okay. We'll just make do and fly the airplane, huh? There we go. Just struggling a little bit. It's fine. We'll get there. All right. Let me go ahead and dim the lights. There we go. Black out the cockpit just a little bit. Take a nap. Whatever. All right, time to snooze. So you go. I hope you guys have had a fantastic week.
November 552 Alpha. Resume on navigation.
Resume on nav.
On navigation. November 552 Alpha.
Okay, let's go ahead and pull this range in just a little bit so we can see what heading we need to fly exactly. Okay, it's looking like probably 087, something like that. Whoops. Yeah. Okay. And it is officially dark. We're very close to it. Sun's doing his best to set over there. We're still about 63 nautical miles out, so we will definitely see the skyline of Boston as we come in, which will be awesome. The lighting in X-Plane 11 at night is really spectacular. Really don't think Laminar gets enough credit for that. Surprisingly few people actually do night flights on YouTube. I guess that's just because there's not a whole lot to see, which I understand. I wish my mouse would go away. I actually can't get it to go off the screen right now. I'm sure that's part of the same glitch that's preventing me from seeing the cockpit controls. Very odd. Okay, we're gonna come left to about 088 here. There we go. Away, mouse. Honestly, I'd expect to get a descent call relatively soon here. At which point we'll slow down a bit. So good to be back in the cockpit. It really is just extremely calming when you've had a rough week. There's something about getting up in the air that just kind of takes all that stress away. Turn back to 090. There's actually a reason I'm not using the GPS navigation. Last time I did that in this airplane, I actually had huge problems with the auto throttles not being adjustable at all, which was odd. So that's kind of why I'm not using the GPS too much here. That's okay, because we don't really need it.
November 5, 5.
Alright, there we go.
Alpha.
Descent call.
Send and maintain 1,000 Kilo Sierra November Charlie. Altimeter 2 9er 9er 2.
down to 1,000. Kilo, Sierra, November, Charlie, altimeter, 2, 9, 9, 2, November, 5, 5, 2, Alpha, Alpha.
November, 5, 5, 2, Alpha, Alpha. Descend and maintain, 1,000. Kilo, India, Juliet, Delta, altimeter, 2, 9, 9, 2.
Yeah, thanks, Ben. I heard you the first time.
Down to 1,000. Kilo, India, Juliet, Delta, altimeter, 2, 9, 9, 2, November, 5, 5, 2, Alpha, Alpha.
Okay, we have a master caution. It's a little bit weird. Go ahead and tap the speed brakes. Slow down a bit. Or the spoilers, I guess, not speed brakes, right? This is not a fighter. Okay. All right, altitude set, speed is set. I guess that master caution just comes on whenever the engines are idle. Yeah, that appears to be the case. Interesting. Kind of some weird bloom effects going on over there by the sunset. That's okay though. See some cars down on the freeway below us. That's super cool. We have a message. Ooh. Low oil pressure. That's probably what that master caution's about, huh? Which would make sense with the engines going to idle. Okay. Alright, well, I'm not sure that there's too much we can do about that, except just taking the auto throttles off, running the engines up, and keeping the spoilers out. So that doesn't sound like a very efficient solution to me, so I guess we'll just kind of disregard that. Probably not the smartest thing, and I'm sure someone in the comments will tell me what I'm doing wrong. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and increase this descent rate just a little bit. Emergency electrical buses are switched off, apparently. Making relatively good time here, I think. No worries. Should be into Boston right on time. Looking for that skyline off in the distance. Sure, we'll be able to see it soon enough. I'm not sure what I have the render distance set to here. But it looks like the airports are popping in long before the actual textures on the ground. Probably be flying the visual approach this evening. About 4 nautical miles to go to our next waypoint, and then we'll be on ATC instruction from then on out, I assume. Yep, looks like we're coming up on a turn here. Okay, gonna go ahead and slow down just a bit more, down to 230. Use the spoilers to help us get there.
November 552 Alpha. Fly heading 050.
050.
Heading 050, November 552 Alpha.
Okay, let's get those spoilers sucked back up. Okay, still no sign of Logan. That might be it off the nose. Way out here, maybe. I'm not sure, to be completely honest. Let's see. Looking for... Boston here. I actually don't see it, which is pretty odd.
November 552 Alpha. Fly heading 050. Descend and maintain 7,000.
You got it.
Heading 050 down to 7,000. November 552 Alpha.
Oh yeah, and now the sun has set almost completely. And there's that lighting I was talking about. Beautiful, absolutely gorgeous. Just really, really pleased with how good this looks for, you know, default scenery. It's awesome. Haven't changed anything about this. Other than just adding in a few aircraft. Okay, and we are below 10,000 feet, so let's go ahead and get our landing and nose lights out. All right. Speed looks good. Altitude's fine. Everything's fine. So I guess Roebuck is actually a fair distance from Boston. Or from Logan, at least. Interesting. Did not realize that. I think it's actually the start of a star, now that I think about it. Seems like Roebuck is one of the standard arrivals into Logan. So that would make sense.
November 552 Alpha. Y heading 030. Vectors for the visual. Runway 33 left. Descend and maintain 5000.
Heading 030. Vectors for the visual. Runway 33 left. Down to 5000. November 552 Alpha. Alpha.
Oh, come on. This is nuts. I can't. That was terrible there. Okay. Let's go ahead and keep our descent going. Down to 5,000, we'll be landing 33 left.
November 552 Alpha Alpha Kilo Sierra Foxtrot Zulu Altimeter 2992
Kilo Sierra Foxtrot Zulu Altimeter 2992 November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Yeah, so a few issues with kind of the cockpit ergonomics. I think that might be a function of me using a track IR more than anything else, just because I have a zoom set up on my mouse scroll wheel, and when I'm trying to actually scroll, you know, if I'm not exactly on point on the cockpit control, then I'll actually zoom instead, which is probably, again, it's more a function of my head moving around on the track IR than anything else. Get that mouse out of here. You're not welcome. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and slow us down even more. Make about 200 knots here. Boston. Appear to be porpoising a little bit. Not too sure what the deal is with that. Let's go ahead and see if we can tell on the map where we're at. Yeah, there's Logan. So we should be getting a turn on to final here. More or less any time. See if I can actually tell. 27. So 33 left is this guy. I don't see an ILS for that, but that's fine. We will just fly the visual. Should get a turn call any second, and the airport should be right out there.
November. 552 Alpha Alpha. Fly heading 150. Descend and maintain 2000.
That's interesting. Okay. Whatever you say, boss.
Heading 150 down to 2000. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Descend and maintain 2000.
Yeah, yeah.
Down to 2000. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Are they about to try and vector us on the final like that? I certainly hope that's not what they're going to attempt to do here. Let's see. But it kind of looks like it might be. So if they try and do that, I'll just cancel the the IFR. Can't be perfect again. But it would be nice if we could just get some good ATC vectors onto a, you know, decent straight-in final here. A little bit of maneuver room. So they might be trying to turn us all the way around. And if that's the case, then I guess that would actually be correct, given that we were, you know, a little bit too high at 5,000. Again, we got that low oil pressure. Warning again, I'm not sure if there's something I'm supposed to be doing here. Oh well. I guess this gives us more of an opportunity to.
November 552.
Well,
Alpha Alpha.
Y spoke too soon.
060.
Okay, and that's not the right turn that I would expect. But we'll go ahead and listen to him for right this second.
Heading 060, November 552, Alpha, Alpha.
Not too sure what the deal is with that. Just looking at the map, trying to figure out what exactly they could be trying to vector us for here. If this is 3-3. Oh no, never mind. I'm an idiot. So this is actually, this is 0-3, and this would be 3-3 left right here, I think. Yeah. Okay, so these vectors are right. Disregard my last. I'm just not very smart. Okay, so we can actually tune this. Cool. So we'll try out the ILS and everything today. Yeah, so this is actually looking pretty correct here. Actually very impressed by this. And 3-3 right is right here. Okay. So we got a nice long runway out in front of us.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Fly heading 360.
You got it, man.
Heading 360. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Okay. There's Boston. Let me go ahead and put out a notch of flaps here. Slow down a bit more. Looks a bit tight to me. Maybe not. My night eyes are not all that well trained here, to be honest. Okay, we got the ILS needle moving here.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Fly heading 330. Report the field in sight.
Heading 330. We'll call the field. November 552 Alpha Alpha. Center. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
We actually have the glide slope as well.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Contact tower on 128.8.
Contact tower on 128.8, November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Let's check in with tower.
Tower, November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Okay, give us our landing clearance, please. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and engage the ILS. It appears to be working just fine. Let me go ahead and get out another notch of flaps here. Slow down to 160. And get that gear out as well. Gonna be getting pretty late landing clearance today, I guess. And slow down to 140, and we will put out another notch of flaps. Leave that as our landing configuration today. Configuration check. Looks like we are good to go.
November 552 Alpha Alpha. Runway 33 left. Clear to land.
Clear to land. Runway 33 left. Cleared to land. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
Very cool. Yeah, so they have made some some massive improvements on the ATC. I think this was actually completely perfect here, this flight at least. I don't think that anything really could have been done any better, so I am a believer at this point in X-Plane, it's ATC. Okay. It looks like the ILS is working on the MD-82. Everything's just coming along real well. Okay, that's a little weird. I'm going to go ahead and disengage the autopilot.
200.
Think rate. Think rate. Think 100. Rate. 100.
50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
There we go. No problem. Thrust reverse is engaged. Disengaging thrust reversers now. Alright. No problem at all. Suck those flaps up. Okay, we should be getting a call from ground, I would expect. So we'll just taxi all the way down to the end of the runway here.
November.
There we go.
552 Alpha Alpha. Gate taxi via 33 left.
Gate taxi via 33 left. November 552 Alpha Alpha.
All right, guys and gals. So we were successfully on the ground in Boston here. What can I say? I mean, they have obviously made some
Alpha, Alpha. Contact ground on 121.9er.
Some serious improvements in the way that ATC is handled. And I am a true believer at this point, so. Like I'm having a problem with getting my thrust reversers to disengage here. Let's see if I can fix this problem.
November,
yeah, they actually won't disengage.
Alpha, Alpha. Are you with me?
I am with you, but I can't talk to you. Okay, guys. Well, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. It looks like we got on the ground with just one minor glitch with the thrust reversers, and I'm not actually sure how to unlock those. So I hope you have all enjoyed the flight with me today. Thanks for visiting. And drop a like if you enjoyed it. Dislike it if you didn't. Let me know what you thought was wrong. And if you really, really enjoyed it and you want to see more X-Plane 11, then get subscribed for the next video, and I will catch you guys then. Peace.